I am delighted to welcome you to this first lecture of Digital Image Processing. Let's start from the introduction of our course. The main objectives to study this course are: we want to get an introduction to fundamental concepts and techniques that are applied in digital image processing. Particularly, our focus will be to learn those techniques that are applied for image enhancement. Within this course, we want to understand and analyze digital image processing problems, and I hope you will be enabled as well to devise algorithms to solve those problems. And last but not least, this course will provide you a solid foundation to further study some advanced courses like computer vision, which have many applications in today's life, because such course like computer vision has prerequisites of digital image processing and artificial intelligence. So this course of digital image processing will be very helpful for you. But I am assuming that you must have some basic programming skills. It doesn't matter whether you already had experience of programming in C, C++, Java, but you must know some basic programming skills, as well as you have the knowledge of data structures and algorithms, and you also must have good concepts in some mathematical subjects like multivariable calculus, differential equations, and linear algebra. This is the textbook, Digital Image Processing, and it's written by Raphael and Richard. Its second edition is available freely in PDF form in internet, and I have given in comment section of this video the link from where you can download this book. So we will follow this book as a textbook throughout the semester. I'm your course instructor, Noman Kadir, and you can contact me throughout the semester with the help of this email address, noman.kadir@fuuasd.edu.pk. Okay, so let's start from the course contents which we will cover in today's lecture. First of all, we will see what is digital images. Then we will see that what is digital image processing, and after that we will get an idea about what's the history of digital image processing and what are the applications of digital image processing, so that you may come to know that how interesting this subject is and how useful this subject and how it is going to affect in nearly every aspect of life today. And finally, at the end of this lecture, we will see some key stages in digital image processing, so that you come to know that what we have to learn in this semester. So let's start from the definition of digital image. A digital image is a representation of a two-dimensional image as a finite set of digital values, and these values are called pixels or picture elements. In fact, you can see digital images just like an array of a two-dimensional array which has rows and columns, and on a intersection of a particular row and column there is a cell that must have some value, and this value is called a pixel. Okay, so when a real world scene like this one is going to be captured by a digital camera, then in fact the analog signals are going to be converted in some discrete set of signals, or you can say in a digital form. And this is the way this this scene is going to be captured in a digital form. And this analog signals to digital signals transformation is sometimes called quantization, which is that which is our topic in next lecture. So the digitization implies that a digital image is just an approximation of a real scene. Just look here. If in real scene the element is just like this, then it may seem to you, it may be it seems to you like this depending upon the resolution of the image. So what's the resolution and like this some sort of these topics, quantization, resolution, these are the topics of our next lecture. So for this moment we just focus that what's the digital images. I repeat, the digital image is just an approximation of a real scene. Through converting the real world analog signals into digital signals. The picture elements, or you can say the pixels, must have some value, and this value can be in one sample for very simple sort of images like black and white images, or you can say the binary images. The black and white images, black and white images or binary images are those images that in which the pixel have only two states, whether it's it is one or it is zero. The one means it is white, or the zero means it is black. Okay, so it means the pixel needs one sample that can be zero or one, just to show that at this particular point the what's the state of light is, whether it is dark or whether it is illuminated. Okay, so this is the case of black and white image. But when you go to its higher level, means the grayscale images like this one, so you can see here here is the another shade of darkness, and here the darkness is here is more darkness, and it means there are many shades of darkness in grayscale. In fact, grayscale image also has one sample for a pixel, but that one sample doesn't have only two states. Instead, that sample has 256 states, because that sample is going to be implemented through one byte of which keeps the value of pixel. And you know that there are 8 bits within one byte. It means 2 raised to power 8 is equal to 256 possible states, right from the darkness to whiteness. It means from black to white there are other 254 states between pure black to pure white. So in total one sample of pixel can represent 256 possible states of illumination of an of a scene what is going to be captured through that grayscale image. Okay, but when you go to color images, then just one sample is not sufficient, because as you know that at least for color images you must have red, green and blue information. So for keeping the red information, it means what's the shade of red is at a particular point. You must have one sample for the red and one sample for green, as well as one sample for blue. So it means in case of color images, at least three samples per point or per pixel are needed to represent such image. So I hope you must got some idea about what's the digital images and how it is going to be represented. Okay, so the next topic is, what is digital image processing? A digital image processing just focuses on two major tasks. First one is the improvement of pictorial information for human interpretation, and sooner or within few weeks, you can say you will be going to implement such applications in which you will be transforming an image to a better image. It means you are going to enhance your image. Okay, so that's the primary purpose of digital image processing, that we want to enhance an image, or you can say we want to enhance our pictorial information, so that it is more useful for human interpretation. Okay, the second main purpose of applying digital image processing is we want to make machines autonomous. By autonomous means they can decide, they can perceive on their own, like robots. So we want that such robots can decide autonomously by seeing the situation. And how the robot is seeing the situation, of course, robot have some digital cameras by which it is going to capture some digital images, and whatever it is going to perceive, it depends that how accurately the robot is going to understand the perceived image. Okay? And this is very important. We must know that there are three processes of digital image processing. First of all, the low-level processing is, then mid-level digital image processing, and then high-level digital image processing. And in fact, high-level digital image processing involves artificial intelligence, and this is some sort of means the high-level image processing is the topic of you can say a computer vision subject, where we are going to learn these concepts. So the major focus of this course is to learn low-level image processing and mid-level image processing. What is low-level image processing? If an image is going to be given as an input to some algorithms of digital image processing, and the algorithm output is it means after applying those digital image processing techniques, the input image is going to be transformed into another image, and that is of course more enhanced image or a better image. So for example, for removing the noise from image, or sharpening an image, or enhancing an image, or image restoration, such kind of applications are low-level image processing. And there is a mid-level in which we are going to give image as input, but we are getting the attributes from that image. Okay? We are not getting another image, rather we have to identify some attributes within that image. So this is mid-level image processing. And its examples are, for example, we want to do some segmentation within the image, or we want to recognize some objects within the image. By segmentation, it means we want to group the pixels within the image based upon some our application. For example, the segmentation can be color-based segmentation, texture-based segmentation, and so on. So we have a complete lecture on segmentation ahead. Okay, so we will study within this course the low level image processes and mid level image processes. And if you want to study high level image processes, then you have to learn computer vision subject, in which the attributes are going to be inputted to high level image processes, and the machines, or you can say the computer, or you can say the boards, are going to understand the situation or perceive the environment based upon the those attributes. Such kind of applications like scene understanding or autonomous navigation involves artificial intelligence and digital image processing. So let's see some history of digital image processing. It goes back to early 90s, then when the first application of digital image was in the newspaper industry. A digital image, which is just like this one, the early digital image, it was just like this one. It was transmitted through some Bartlein cable, and such images were transferred by submarine cable from London to New York. And there are some other applications within mid 20s. For example, this is the improved image at that time. So there are some applications where new reproduction processes on photographic techniques were introduced, and such basic kind of work were done within digital image processing. And here we come to 1960s. So it means within this era of 20s to 60s, there were no any major achievement or something that is discussable. So in 1960s, the digital image processing had some advanced applications, like in 1964 a picture was taken from moon, and then it is transmitted through satellite. And of course within this transmission there must be some degradation, and to identify that degradation and remove the noise from that image, it was the, you can say, the first kind of application at that time. And here we go to 1970s. Here is an application of medical image processing in 1979. These professors got a Nobel Prize for inventing a new technology that is called computerized axial tomography, CAT scans. So you can say that this is a major change within the history of digital image processing. But when we go to 80s and after 80s, there are many applications of digital image processing, and this area has exploded, and they are now used for all kind of tasks, I mean in nearly every areas, like image enhancement, restoration, artistic effects, medical visualization, industrial inspection, law enforcement, human computer interface. We will get some sketches of these kind of applications within the next section of this lecture. Let's see, there are many applications of digital image processing now. For example, one of the most common application of digital image processing is to improve quality, or to improve to remove noise from the image. let's see, for example, this one is the from an example from medical imaging. Let's see, here is the input image, and this is the image after applying digital image processing. You can see the output image is more interpretable as compared to the input image. Similarly, here and in this input image, there is much noise, and that is going to be very much reduced here within the output image. And here is another application of digital image processing, where the picture is taken from satellite in daylight. So you can say that after processing this picture, within this picture, that's the output of image processing algorithm. Here you can see more information about what kind of population is residing here and what kind of location is it it is. So these are some applications of digital image processing within the area of image enhancement. So here we go to another application. You may be know about this telescope Hubble, because it's a very famous telescope. It was launched in 1990, and it can take very distant object images. For example, this image of some galaxy, but there is not information, proper information is visible from here. And this image, after applying digital image processing, this image is going to be converted within this image, and you can see the there is huge difference between the input and output. So this is one of the application of digital image processing. Similarly, DIP can be used, digital image processing can be used to create some special artistic effects that make, for example, some movie more visually appealing. So within the medical imaging, there are many applications of digital image processing. For example, here is an application of dog's heart. And this is very simple algorithm applied here that detects the edges within this image, and based upon this algorithm, the boundary of between the types of tissues is detected here, and you can do such edge detection within few weeks after learning some basic techniques of digital image processing. Okay, here comes another application from geographic information systems. So the digital image processing techniques are used in meteorology department as well, because the images taken from satellites are not in a proper form, and they must be degraded, and there must be some noise in those images, and that noise has to be removed from those images. And also the image enhancement has to be made to make those images more informative. Here are some applications from industry. So the human operators are slow, and maybe you can say sometimes unreliable, but machines are not, you know. So in industrial vision systems, image processing is applied at many places. For example, just see this picture. If such image is going to be given to some computer, then computer can identify this product, that this is the damaged product, because it is not properly filled. This bottle is not properly filled. And similarly, for example, in medicine industry, when such kind of medicines are going to be packed, then we can place robots there which are just seeing those products, and if they find, for example, some missing pill here, then they just mark such product as not a good one to place it in the market. And it means the machines can do a decision in an autonomous way in industry. Here are some applications from law enforcement departments. For example, number plate recognition of a vehicle, and similarly some fingerprint recognition, or for example some surveillance applications which involve the security. The image captured by CCTV cameras is not usually the very informative image, so it has to be enhanced. So the CCTV images can be enhanced to make it more informative. So such kind of digital image processing applications are going to be used in law enforcement departments. Similarly, there are many HCI, human computer interaction or human computer interfaces applications that are going to be used, for example, in face recognition or gesture recognition. These applications are very common now. For example, in your mobile, maybe you are using such kind of application of face recognition. Okay, so this is all about the applications of digital image processing. Now come to the last topic of our today's lecture, and that is about key stages in digital image processing. In digital image processing, the first stage is, of course, image acquisition. By acquisition means how the analog signals of real world are going to be captured by camera, and how the analog image is going to be transformed into the digital image. Such kind of process is called quantization, as I told you before, and we will study it in next lecture. We will start the image processing proper subject from that topic. So this is the first application, because first of all we want to know that how the image is going to be acquired on something two-dimensional like something. So after image acquisition, we will study, or you can say the next key stage in image digital image processing is image enhancement. So for example, here the input image, you can see here that the input image is not the good one, but and it is going to be very much reduced if we enhance its contrast here. And for enhancing such contrast, there are some histogram equalization or like these techniques are available in digital image processing, and you will learn those techniques. Okay, and also we will learn many transformation techniques, or many kind of filters, whether those filters are spatial filters or frequency domain filters. So we will apply those filters to enhance the image. So the major portion of our semester of this course is going to be devoted for this kind of task. So I hope you will be very much expert at the end of this course within this particular area of image enhancement. Next key stage in image processing is image restoration. So for example, you can see this image. This image is taken from the moon surface, and you can see this within this input image there is noise, and after removing that noise, this image, we get a very good and informative image here. If you just see it deeply, you can see that this noise is of a particular kind where there are regular patterns within of noise, regular pattern of noise within this input image. So in such kind of regular noise, the frequency domain filters do very good work, and we will study it within our course. Next, morphological image processing. So the morphological image processing techniques are usually applied to remove imperfections that sometimes introduced during segmentation. And in fact, the segmentation's output is a binary image, or you can say bi-level image. So it means such kind of applications are going to be applied on binary images like this one. So if you see this input image, you can see some imperfections here, and after processing and throughout this whole process, the final product is very much better than this one. So imperfections are removed from this image, and this is because of morphological processing. We have two or three lectures on morphological image processing, so don't worry about it now. Next is segmentation. Segmentation is sometimes applied to extract particular kind of information from the image. You can say sometimes segmentation is applied for grouping the pixels of the image, or for example, like there are many types of segmentation, for example texture based segmentation, for example color based segmentation, and so on. For example, see here the application of segmentation. This is the input image, and when you see after segmentation, the shadow of this object is removed from this image. So we just identified these kind of pixels that are making shadow of object. So after deducting those pixels, or you can say we can extract the object without shadow here. So there are many applications of segmentation, and we have some lectures on segmentation as well. Next is object recognition. We will study these all topics of enhancement and restoration, morphological image processing, and segmentation. Then after that, there are some advanced topics of object recognition. So it is a kind of mid-level image processing in which we can identify within the input image some attributes, or based upon those attributes we can identify some objects. Next is representation and description. This is very interesting topic, and we have a lecture on it at the end of this course. Approximately that's one of the last lectures. And this is very interesting topic because we want to see here that within the image the objects can be represented in numeric form or like this data. So that's very interesting. Image compression, we will also see some basic techniques that how the image is going to be compressed, like you are using some image forms like JPG. That's basically the compressed image. So we will see some techniques at the end of this course, and also we will see the color image processing techniques. So this is all. These are some key stages in digital image processing, and I hope you got an idea that what we are going to study and learn, and also will implement within this course. So that's all for today, and thank you.